Hello, everyone, and good evening. Thank you. Tonight, I'm going to talk about the project that first drew me to Barbados and the journey that it's taken me on. I'm from Seattle, and in 2013, I saw a graph that would change my life. Now, I have to warn you, it's going to be a little underwhelming. Here it is. So we're looking at obesity rates in Barbados, in green for males and in purple for females. And you'll see that women's obesity rates are almost double that of men in 2010. Now, as many of you know, obesity is linked with increased risk of type 2 diabetes, hypertension, and other chronic conditions. So when I saw this graph, I wondered, does this gender differential in obesity rates translate into a gender difference in disease? Unfortunately, the answer seems to be yes. In Barbados, women's diabetes rates are 30% higher than men. Part of the explanation has to do with physical activity. Only 1 out of 10 women get enough activity. That's only 1 out of 10. And to understand why this is such a big problem, imagine that I could give you a pill. Now, this pill would reduce your risk of colon cancer by 30%, your risk of breast cancer by 20 to 40%, and even if you have a family history of diabetes, this pill would reduce your risk by 40%. It sounds pretty good, right? This is exactly what physical activity can do. So I set out to try to answer the following question. Why are women in Barbados not getting enough physical activity? And you can imagine, as an outsider, I faced a major disadvantage in trying to answer this question. I didn't know anything. But this actually turned out to be helpful, because it meant I really had to look and I really had to listen to try and figure out what was going on. So what are some of the things that I saw as an outsider? For one, when I started this research, everyone told me that I was wasting my time, that there was a simple explanation. Bajan men prefer sweet, thick women. or as Captain Sawyer would say, don't want no broomstick girl, I like them big and fat and thick. Now, there might be some truth to this story, but I'm going to argue that there is a much more complicated narrative going on. For one thing, most of the women that I spoke with wanted to lose weight. They told me stories about crazy diets, expensive surgeries, dangerous pills. No one wanted to be bony either, but everyone wanted to shed a few pounds. So why is it so difficult? For one thing, girls are socialized to be less active than boys from an early age. We tell young women to become girls, to stop sweating, to stop playing around as much. You can even see in this picture, the boys are kicking around a football while the girls are standing up, chatting. And this dynamic continues well into adulthood. Two, a lot of the women that I spoke with were mothers, and a lot of them were single mothers. In fact, in Barbados, 30 to 40% of all households are headed by a single mother. And as you know, these women are responsible for so much, from cooking, cleaning, pressing, taking to children to school, collecting them, working. There's just so much for any woman to do. These gendered ideas about who is responsible for what within the household have a very real impact on A, whether women have any free time, and B, how they choose to use the limited free time they may have. Now, despite all these barriers, I did find one exciting bright spot. One of the women that I spoke with told me about a dance fitness class that she was so excited about. She talked me into going to it that very night, and it really was amazing. Pictured here in yellow is Miss Heather Drakes, the woman who teaches this class. Now, Heather only charges $3 for women to attend, and the women who do come report less shortness of breath, increased weight loss, and an increased ability to manage their hypertension and their diabetes. For me, this is like finding the pot of gold at the end of the public health rainbow. I was so excited. Here is an intervention that's proven to work in the Caribbean and has a real health impact. So I partnered with Heather and the Physical Activity Task Force, the Ministry of Health, with the help of Maria Holder and PAHO, to try to scale up this intervention. We trained a cohort of community-based fitness trainers, some of whom are pictured here, to teach their own $3 classes in different parishes across the island. And so far, it seems like it really is working to attract women who might not otherwise be active. This is a quotation from a woman who emailed us about the classes. I am a mother of two young boys with a strong family history of diabetes, and therefore I'm keen to get some regular exercise, but I'm not really a gym person. This is exactly the kind of woman that we're hoping this program will appeal to. A program like this has the potential to be so powerful because it directly addresses the barriers that women face. One, as I mentioned, women are socialized away from being active, but dancing is a major exception. Dancing is an activity that women are supposed to be good at, that we're encouraged to do. Two, while exercise is perceived as being expensive and not very fun, it's no surprise that women wouldn't make it a priority in the face of so many competing demands. But if we can make physical activity something that's affordable, fun, and social, we can make it a little bit more appealing. We can make it something that women are willing to squeeze in to their busy schedules. When I first started this research, people implicitly told me that women were responsible for their own overweight status, their own obesity, their own inactivity. But the story that I saw was quite different. Women face a lot of very real barriers to being active. And if we want to create physical activity interventions that are going to be successful, we have to design them with women's needs, values, and preferences in mind. And I do believe that if we listen to women, and if we commit to investing in them, we can create a healthier, happier, and more empowered Barbados. Thank you.